Morning, good morning, beautiful, beautiful friends of mine. So I just woke up and I am super excited for today because it's going to be just a great day. Although it's a little cloudy outside today, I have a lot going on, a lot of good calls today, and just had a really good day yesterday, so might as well have a great day today. So I'm on my way to cardio. I just have my fasted, doing 25 minutes now every single, well, 5 times a week. What a great feeling. I am on my way back to the house really quick, which is legit just across the street. And I have to get my breakfast together, my pre-workout meal together, because I am heading into Tampa to my chiropractor. I go to Navigate Chiropractic and I'm getting an adjustment, and then I am heading straight back to go to Crunch on my side. Going to make my first meal right now. Well, today we're just going to do like a full day of eating, so it'll be super simple. Navigate Chiropractor with my chiropractor, and she's going to tell us some things about the work she does on me, my x-rays that I had, and what I've been going through. If you've been going through something like this too, maybe you should search someone out like her and get some help. So real quick, we're gonna do a little interview style and get going talking about everything.
Well, hi guys, I'm Dr. Kaylee. Navigate Chiropractic is our office here. Allie's been seeing us for probably a little over 4 months now. When she first started, obviously we had a lot of stuff going on. Mm-hmm. With a lot of training comes a lot of breakdown of the body, which we expect. But if you're breaking it down, you gotta build it back up. So we adjust, we're a neurologically based office. Instead of Allie just coming in and saying, hey, my neck hurts, my hips hurt, and we're just whacking and cracking everywhere, we're a lot more specific. So when Allie comes in, we actually look at her leg length based on an Achilles reflex. And the Achilles reflex is a neurological reflex, and so that's where the technique's name comes from. And it allows us to figure out where to adjust based on what her body needs as of this moment, instead of just basing it off of symptoms, which if any of you guys work out, you know a lot about compensations, and compensation patterns aren't going to do anything for the body if we're just treating symptoms. So when we adjust, we use this. It's called the integrator. When you squeeze it back, it locks into place. Some other chiropractic instruments, you can click a bunch of times and you can push as hard as you want, but this one stays locked backwards. And then when we go to adjust, we just press down and it makes that click noise, and that's what fires to move the bone. And it lines it back up in order to take the stress off of the muscles in the area, but really takes the pressure off of the nerves. And that's what allows the body to start to heal and start to communicate a lot better. When we started, so her hips were one of the main problems. She told me on her first visit she felt crooked. Makes sense, because you were crooked. So because of that, we were getting some imbalances. That also would create muscle imbalances. I think you even mentioned you felt like your glutes were imbalanced and one muscle.
Yeah, was like bigger. I could tell in pictures and stuff that my left was almost more developed. And when I do like any type of hinge movement, it felt really off.
Absolutely, and so the back of the glutes will come up and they attach on the top of these bones and also on the bottom of those bones.
Okay.
So it made sense that she was feeling off, she could see imbalances, we could see imbalances in her spine. This type of imbalance here can definitely be even. It's gonna take time, so we're gonna retake her x-rays in a year's time. Her neck, when she started, was very, very straight. A curvature in the neck should be anywhere from 30 to 40 degrees. Allie was at 3. 0.7. Very straight neck. This number should really be 0, but her head was starting to lean forward. So when this number starts to increase, these muscles start to get a lot tighter. And so that trap muscle that attaches up It goes to the base of the head and then out to the shoulders and down into the mid back.
Okay.
Starts to get tighter.
Yeah, because when I came in, I came to you and I was like, so I'm to the point where I can't even use my thumbs at night.
Yeah. So thumbs are important, we should be able to use them.
Yeah, we need those.
But with most people nowadays on technology, we're looking down in our laps, our heads are leaning forward, and so instead of having that C-shaped curve this direction, a lot of people start to get straight like you did, or they'll start to reverse. At that point, for younger kids, later on it turns into neck pain, numbness and tingling, more muscle spasms, stuff like that people typically think about chiropractic for. Realistically, what I'm looking for is that nerve connection and the flow to organs. And so we've been working hard on getting Allie some curve in her neck, which is what her homework is.
Gotcha.
So really seeing a chiropractor is the best in conjunction with what you're doing at home.
Yeah, definitely. Hip-wise and hand-wise, like I'm noticing huge differences in my workouts. And sometimes I still get the thumb numbness, but I'm a lot more aware of like how my posture is, how I'm sleeping and laying and all that stuff. Yeah.
Is there just like a couple tips you would suggest for people who are like maybe in the fitness world that are having issues?
Being more aware, you guys are always more aware of your posture when you're working out, right? Because the alignment is important. Mm-hmm. But at home, almost everybody goes home and they slump down on the couch and they sit on their cell phones like this.
Yeah.
They put their laptop on their lap, which it's the terrible name for a laptop. It shouldn't be. It should be up on a countertop.
Right. And everyone, I feel like in this world, like the fitness industry, we're all online coaches and working on our computer all the time. Instagram posts and videos.
Everything is on social media, so getting that laptop up higher, either rise it, stand while you're on it, like on the countertop or a bar height table, so it's at eye level. That's the most important thing, just bring things up to you so your head can be back on your shoulders.
Sweet.
Sleep is a huge thing. A lot of people are belly sleepers, which is the worst position you should be in. You really should be a back sleeper with a very small pillow, otherwise you're on your back and your head pushes forward with 15 pillows.
Yeah.
Or on your side. Your side, you should have a bigger pillow, but also one between your knees as well. That at least tries to keep your spine in a better alignment. So little things, you know, carrying a purse that's a crossbody instead of on one shoulder, men not sitting on wallets. Little things like that. If you're hiking up a purse that's 15 pounds all day long, you're gonna start having spinal issues.
Well, thank you so much taking this time to like explain to everyone what they need to get better. So
absolutely, hope you guys learned something.
All right,
start. Typical life expectancy of a man in this day and age is 78 years old. So.
All right, so I just got to the gym and do my mobility and my stretching first. I am going to record this workout for you, so stay tuned. We're going to do a killer shoulder workout. Anyway, I will see you guys on the inside. just smashed my shoulders. Hope you guys enjoy that workout, and just got done with my 20 minutes of walking on incline, and I am rushing home because I have a posing session with one of my clients and then a phone call right after that. I like living stuff on the edge and cutting times close. You notice I'm late for everything. So we're about to grill out. We have about 4 pounds of chicken, about a pound and or 2 pounds of beef, and then everything else is upstairs. Upstairs I have a salmon fillet, that's 2 pounds, turkey meat, and I'm gonna have 1 meal of eggs and egg whites, 2 meals of chicken, 1 meal of salmon, and 2 meals of ground turkey. Carb-wise, I already made it all. I have quinoa, brown rice, white potatoes, and sweet potatoes all cooked up for me, Michael. Veggie-wise, I have tomatoes, cucumbers, salad mix that is like lettuce and shredded lettuce and spinach. I also have broccoli this time. So we're just keeping it really simple. I'm really trying to clean up my diet, sticking to the plan. So I am not going to have like, you know, subs as much anymore. I might sub like an English muffin for like my oats, but that's gonna be as extreme as we're getting here, guys. You know, if you're cutting and you're trying to get to that extreme level of leanness, this is the sacrifice you're going to have to make. Flexible dieting is, in my opinion, not the way to go. But you know what? Everyone has their opinions and also what's worked for them. For my body specifically, I don't see as good results. I also don't have the same amount of energy as I do when I eat whole foods. Hey guys, what's up? Okay, so I did a little bit of a question and answer on my Instagram the other day. Decided I would, you know, record some of that for this episode. And right before this, you kind of saw like a day in the life. That's like my normal Monday. And then I also got asked like a full day of eating. So I started showing you my breakfast the other day. And once again, I just stopped recording by accident. I'm so sorry. But I'm about to show you right after I'm done grilling out this food, how I prep it, how I bulk prep it, and also what I'm eating currently right now every single day. One of my pro tips would be if you're somebody who does have issue staying with the diet, then I would either recommend planning your preps very strategically to where you know that your food won't run out, or making sure you are pre-prepping meal by meal instead of bulk prepping or cooking as you go. I did have a couple more questions from my friend Cece, and I'll go ahead and read what she said, and they're a little bit more mindset based, and that makes me excited because I'm like feeling so pumped talking about mindset and just like life. She goes, girl, you're mentally strong, and I think that is the most challenging to conquer, and that didn't happen overnight. So how did you get there? What habits, and how did you get a mind shift blocking out the negative? I admire your focus. I constantly struggle on mindset shifting and revert back to my negative ways. First, I want to say thank you for asking that question. And also thank you for appreciating what I try to be good at. I think it's a really interesting question just because to an outsider perspective, looking back on where I was, I can say that I am strong mentally at times, but I've also been really weak mentally, and it's really easy to forget and to kind of judge yourself against others and thinking that they have it all, that they know it all, that they're good at what they do, and they don't have those bad days or bad weeks and months. Real quick little backstory on me. I know I said I talked about this in episode one, and one part that really was hard for me this off season wasn't like necessarily the weight gain and how I looked. Like, I actually got really comfortable with that after a couple months. Like, whatever, I've been this weight before, it happened again, I enjoyed my time, still put on a lot of lean muscle. So there's no regrets in that sense. Where was I going with this? In October, November, I just felt myself always in this hole, always trying to pull myself out, and always just feeling mentally weak. You know, I didn't have any people around me. Like, the only people I really saw was like my boyfriend and family and maybe Gina. I really struggled with my day-to-day activities and my negative thinking, and before I even realized it, I would be rolling down a hill with negative thoughts and be so consumed that some days, especially on weekends when Michael was off or whenever I had things I had to get done, instead of just working and getting things done and, you know, doing things like a normal person would, I would like be crippled in fear and not be able to get anything done. And I felt so out of control in that sense. And it was very hard for me because I'm the type of person that's like, get shit done and just go after it and deal with it. Being in that mindset where I just couldn't push past like how I was feeling made me feel really weak. And I guess one thing I can say about this is I made quite a few changes since then. And I have to say that this is the happiest like I've been in a few years, guys. I don't think I've been this happy since like 2018. There's a lot of issues coming out of 2018 with moving to Florida and with my relationships, and just a lot was going on. You know, you can control one area of your life, and that's the area that I show you all, like my workouts and, you know, my daily stuff and kind of the grind. But I never really show you, and neither does so many fitness competitors or just, you know, IG people, like the day-to-day struggles, how we go through those highs and those lows. Now, with all that being said, I'm not gonna go too much deeper in that because that's a story for like a different vlog. I'll do a story time, I promise. What do I do in the means of being strong, and what habits? So what I've changed most since November was the time I spend with myself. I've spent a lot of time with myself. Like, I haven't had a job, like a job outside of my home since May, but that didn't make me happy. It actually made me sad. And it was up until I realized that I needed to spend time meditating. I've meditated almost every single day since December. And through meditation and through journaling, I've really just been able to be a lot more clear with my intentions, with my goals, with my vision, with what I desire. And it's really, really interesting to just see such a shift in my mind, and it's been really amazing. Another thing that I've done is I started reading. I started a book club in January, and it's kind of funny that I started a book club because it's honestly something I'm not great at. I've hated literature in school. I decided it would be a good challenge, and I'm freaking loving it. And if you all are in my book club already, thank you. If you're not, it's really simple. Like, we just read one book a month and we discuss it weekly. I think it's just a really good way to learn and to get other people's opinions and just to grow as a person. Where was I going with this? So I did meditating, journaling with my reading. I don't read every single day, but I do read my designated chapters, which has been about 2 to 3 chapters of a book a week. Depending on how long the book is. Those are some of the main things I changed. I also try to think about how I am perceiving things. Those are some of the things that really helped me. Habit-wise, it's just being very intentional with everything you do. You have to remember the food affects you, the amount of sleep you get affects you. So what does that mean? Prep your meals, eat healthy food, eat whole foods, eat foods that agree with your body. Go to sleep at a time where you can get at least 7 to 8 hours of sleep at night. If you need more, go to bed earlier. If you can't fall asleep easily, okay, well, instead of just complaining about that, put away your phone, your tablet, your laptop, your TV, turn off all the blue lights, buy blue light blockers. There's so many things you can do instead of making excuses. And those daily habits are going to add up. And on top of that, it's really just being able to observe yourself and reaching out for help. So I haven't really talked about this too much, but I actually hired a life and business coach, and he's been a blessing to my life, and he's really opened up my eyes to all the things that I thought I knew, wanted to know, and tried to know. But until I had someone lead me through it and really challenge my thinking, I don't know if I could have gotten this far without him. Maybe in a year, maybe with a lot more self-development work. You know, that's kind of what gave me the inspiration to build this program that I'm about to launch, is seeing how much of an impact this has made on my life. And I made a program that I went through. Like, it's changed my life. That was probably a combination of all the things that have helped me shift my mindset. And when I am feeling down, the last thing you need to do is go get more down on yourself. So to snap out of things, I like to get outside, or I'll text my coach, or I'll go hang out with a friend. I'll do something where my vibe and my frequency is going to raise up and get me out of that low that I'm in. And when I can feel a low coming, I analyze what is happening right now. And that's how you know that you're starting to become a more mindful person and more aware, when you can stop yourself and ask questions and try to understand why a thought is stirring in your mind and why you're feeling a certain way. And are you letting the emotions take over, or are you stopping them and you're observing them and then analyzing them so you can change them, right? If there's something that you really want, you just have to really think about it. How much time have you spent visualizing it? How much time have you spent trying to figure yourself out and figuring out what you want? And you know, for me, getting to that point was extremely challenging. Honestly, it felt impossible. And the last few months have really cleared up my mind. You have to declutter your mind first before you can accept more information and really think. So I think the first step is decluttering your mind. And to do that, you just have to do like the things I just talked about. So yeah, that is probably the best advice I can give at the moment without going super deep or becoming like a crazy hippie. Other than that, I did want to hit on, I applied for the first form, Athlete Search. Decided to, why not? I have always been the type of person who's wanted to apply for the first form searches or like the bodybuilding.com searches, and I've always pushed out because it involves a video. And this time I'm not going to, because like, why not try? And just like saying that makes me so happy, and it kind of just shows everything just keeps compiling and getting better and better. And it's just, I'm so proud of all the work that I've been putting in and overcoming my fears and my doubts recently, and just being so much more open and aware of how I was acting and, you know, the person that I am. And, you know, I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to say for this first form video, except how I feel like I can make a change. And gosh, I've been experiencing so much love and happiness recently, and I've been taking what I've been taught and giving it to my clients, and I've seen so much growth. Sorry guys, oh my god. I've seen so much growth in them, and I never realized that I had the ability to change people's lives like that. Like, I always wanted to, and I always thought I had the potential, and you know, it was kind of like one of those visions and those far off dreams where it's like, yeah, I can do anything I want. I want to be a coach, and I want to change people's lives, and I want to make an impact, like blah blah blah. And that's kind of how I felt as a coach. I didn't have the confidence. Like, I had clients, I have a coaching business, I make my living off of my coaching business, but I wasn't happy. And I always kept telling people, like, I want to focus on mindset. Something about mindset. And it's kind of interesting that I'm like reaching out for first form, because like my biggest inspirations, like, that have got me to this point in my life, like, I've been a fan of Andy Frisella and Vaughn and Emily Hayden since they probably even had an Instagram or a website or their podcasts. And I've been a huge supporter, and I know the MF CEO, that got me through pretty much my 2018 prep. Emily Hayden also, when she started her podcast last year, it got me through that slump I was in. And I remember going through highs and lows, and my highs always revolved around whenever she'd release a podcast, and I would just like soak all of her energy in. And then, like, you know, my energy just kept going back down, and I started to realize, there was a list of other people, but these are some of the main ones that have made an impact in my life. And I just realized that, you know, if they can do this, I can do this too. I just need to figure my shit out, keep learning, and keep adopting all these daily skills and lifestyle habits that they keep talking about. Because, like, I kind of had it, but I didn't have it. And I just have to say, like, after these last few months, like, I feel like I finally have it. Like, maybe not 100%, but you know, like, I see the path, like, I see the yellow brick road, laying out in front of me that I can go hop down. and be happy with my clients and with my family and with my boyfriend and my everything. And to have the opportunity to reach more people and make more of a difference and further my competing career and just meet awesome people is all I feel like I need in my life right now. And I've met so many great people. My gosh, wow, I don't know why I'm getting so emotional. Having like a family that I can call, whether it's a supplement family or like a competing family, I don't care what it is, it's just like so special to me. And I've went through a lot of shit in my life and I've worked really hard for everything I have and everything I've gotten. I'm not trying to stop anytime soon. And I know what I have inside of me is special. And on a later note, I'm obsessed with the core values. Half of them are like in my own vision, mission statements. And, you know, I kind of came up with that just by analyzing what my core values and strengths were. And I just realized like there's a quote that always stuck with me for ever since I can remember hearing, and it may have been Emily who said it first. I don't know. And it said, "You already have everything you need inside of you." And that just like struck a chord with me. And I kind of based my vision and my mission off of that. And I'm a leader. I never thought I could be one when I was younger. I just had a lot of limiting beliefs and I was like shy. I mean, I couldn't even like talk to people, and now I'm stepping on stage as an IFBB pro. It's pretty mind-blowing. And I know that if I can do it, you can do it too. And if I can overcome things, you can too. And that's where my passion and my mission and my vision and everything comes from, and stems from all that. And loyalty is definitely one of my biggest core values. And so is firstborn, so we kind of match. None of it was planned. That kind of just rolled off the tongue a lot nicer than I thought it would. So yeah, go Allison. Anyway, all right, guys. So we're gonna end this little cry sesh and firstborn intro update application. I don't know what it really is now. And I am going to show you this beautiful sunset that I get to watch every single night. I am oh so grateful for where I live here in Florida, but it's pretty awesome. My chicken and hamburgers are still waiting to be grilled, so I'm about to go over there and do that. And up next, you will see me prepping my food. So I will talk to you guys later. All right, so real quick, I'm just going to show you what I'm eating this week. My meals down to a T. They are super regimened, and I'm not going to eat anything off my plan. Although I might switch out like some meats. Right now, I'm just going to show you really quick what my six meals look like right now and what I'm currently eating. If you look over here, I have my normal first meal. Now this sometimes changes. Right now it's 3 whites, a whole, 40 grams of blueberries, a half a cup of oats, cinnamon, stevia, and a slight bit of sunflower seeds because I like the crunch. Meal two is pre-workout. It's a cup of rice, 3 ounces of chicken. Meal three is post-workout. It's a cup of rice, 4 ounces of chicken, and a cup of veggies. Meal four is chicken, 5 ounces of sweet potatoes and veggies. Meal five is salmon, I think 3.5 ounces, and then 4 ounces of potato with cucumber and spinach, kind of like a salad. And then meal five is a taco salad, and I add shredded lettuce. So that's a really simple, I add some salsa, and then with these, I just have mustard, tot sauces, and salsa. So there's my week. Not too upset because I know that this is the easy part, and I still have so much food in my diet, and I'm 14 weeks out. So we're about to grind hard though. My weight hasn't really dropped much, and that will come in my next vlog about my check-ins. More to come with that, and until then, I will see you guys next week.